जय परम पूज्य पाद परिव्राज आचार्य विष्णु पाशल भक्ति विज्ञान भारती गोस्वामी महाराज जी की जय। जय परम पूज्य पाद श्री श्रीमद भक्ति साधक मुनि महाराज जी की जय। पूजनीय वैष्णव वृंद की जय। पूजनीय गुरुवर्ग वृंद की जय। समागत गौर भक्त वृंद की श्री हरि नाम संकीर्तन की जय। गौर प्रेमान महाराज कम नरसिंह महाराज विल नॉट कम ही विल कम देन यू गिव एट वन टाइम फॉर हिम यू विल गिव ऑलरेडी यू ब्रॉट एंड इट्स नॉट गुड लेट महाराज कम यस वंदे अहम श्री गुरु श्रीयुता पदकमलां श्री गुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्री रूपं साग्रजातं सहगना रघुनाथान्वितं तां सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान् सहगणा ललित श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च Where did he go? Then who will play kartal? No, any of them don't sing. Call him. And where is Damodar? He is not here today. Gurudev Kripa Bindu Diya. कृपा बिंदु दिया करये दासे त्रिनापेक्षाति हीना गुरुदेव कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ये दासे त्रिनापेक्षायति न सकल सहने बल दिया कर सकल सहने बल दिया कर निज माने स्पृहाहीना निज माने स्पृहाहीना कृपा बिंदु दिया करये दासे त्रिनापेक्षायति हीना कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ये दासे त्रिनापेक्षायति दीना सकले सन्मान करिते शाकति Dehanathaya thaya thaya sakale sanman karite shakati Dehanathaya thaya thaya tave to gaibo Hari nama sukhe tave to gaibo Hari nama sukhe aparatha have hata aparatha have hata aparatha have hata अपराध हवे हात कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ये दासे त्रिनापेक्षायति हीना कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ये दासे त्रिनापेक्षायति कावे हेनो कृपा लभियाए जान कृतार्थ हाई वेनात कावे हेनो कृपा लभियाए जान कृतार्थ हाई वेनात शक्ति बुद्धिहीन आमी अति दीन शक्ति बुद्धि करो मोरे आत्मसात करो मोरे आत्मसात कर मोरे आत्मा कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ये दासे त्रिनापेक्षायति हीना कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ये दासे त्रिनापेक्षायति योग्यता विचारे किचु नहीं पाए तुमार करुणा सार योग्यता विचारे किचु नहीं पाए तुमार करुणा सार करुणा ना होले कांदिया कांदिया करुणा ना हले कांदिया कांदिया प्राण ना राखीबो आर प्राण ना राखीबो प्राण ना राखीबो आर प्राणना राखीबो आर कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ये दासे त्रिनापेक्षायति हीना कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ये दासे त्रिनापेक्षायति कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ये दासे त्रिनापेक्षायति हीना कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ये दासे त्रिनापेक्षा जय गुरुदेव जय गुरुदेव जय Jai Gurudev Jai Jai Gurudev Jai Gurudev Jai Gurudev Jai Gurudev Jai Gurudev Jai Gurudev Jai Jai Gurudev Jai Guru Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Sri Advaita Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Sri Advaita Sri Krishna Chaitanya Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Sri Advaita Gaura Bhakta Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Krishna Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda
Ohe Vaishnava Thakur
O he Vaishnava Thakura Dayara Sagara Edase Karuna Kari O he Vaishnava Thakura Dayara Sagara Edase Karuna Kari Vaishnava Thakura Dayara Sagara Edase Karuna Kari O he Vaishnava पद छाया शोधा है हमारे तुम्हार चरण धरी दिया पद छाया तुम्हार चरण धरी छाया वेगादमी छाए दोषा शोधि छाए गुणा देह दासे छाय वेगादमी छाय दोषा छाए सत्संग देहा है हमारे छाए देहा है ए बसे ची संगेर आशे बसे ची संगेर आशे एकाकी आमा नाही पाए बल हरि नाम संकीर्तने काकी आमाय नहीं पाए तुमी कृपा करी श्रद्धा बिंदु दिया तुमी कृपा करी श्रद्धा बिंदु तुमी कृपा करी श्रद्धा बिंदु दिया तुमी कृपा करी श्रद्धा बिंदु दिया देह कृष्ण नाम धने देह कृष्ण नाम धने कृष्ण से तो मा कृष्ण दीते पार तुम्हार शक्तियाचे कृष्ण से तुम्हार कृष्ण दीते पार तुम्हार आमी तो कांगाल कृष्ण कृष्ण बली आमी तो कृष्ण कृष्ण बलि आमी तो कांगाल कृष्ण कृष्ण बलि आमी तो कांगाल कृष्ण कृष्ण हे धाई तव पाछे पाछे धाई तव धाई तव पाछे पाछे धाई तव पाछे अमी तो कांगा कृष्ण कृष्ण बलि धाई तव पाछे पाछे आमी तो कांगाल कृष्ण कृष्ण बोली दयाल वैष्णव ठाकुर 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 This kirtan, our previous acharyas has glorified Vaishnavas. Vaishnavas are very special. They are Vaishnav is considered as Guru. The Gurudev who gave us initiation is our Gurudev. Along with this, even Vaishnavas are considered as Guru. Vaishnav is very dear to Krishna. In the path of spiritual life, the most dangerous thing is Vaishnavaprad. Vaishnavaprad is so dangerous, even a person attained the level of bhava also can fall down if he commits Vaishnavaprad. It is such a dangerous thing. And the mercy of Vaishnav is so strong, so powerful, it can bestow us everything. Lord is bound to come if Vaishnavas are merciful. That is the reason in this kirtan it is said, Oh hey Vaishnav Thakur, Dayar Sagar, you are the ocean of mercy. So please be merciful on me. Edase Karuna Kari, you please be merciful upon me. Diya Pada Chaya, you please give me shelter in your lotus feet. If Vaishnavas give shelter, then only we can go close to Gurudev. By the mercy of Vaishnavas, we will be able to understand about Gurudev. We can connect ourselves with Gurudev. And that Vaishnav appears in the form of Siksha Guru in the life of many people. So it is said that by the mercy of Vaishnava we can go close to Gurudev and by the mercy of Gurudev we can go close to Mahaprabhu and Radha Krishna. So we have to beg for the shelter in the lotus feet of Vaishnavas. You please give us shelter. And then what you will do? You please purify me. I am now polluted. What is the pollution? This desire to enjoy this material world is pollution. So he says, you please purify me. Where is that kirtan? I want to see that kirtan. It's open, please give me. Tomar Charna Dhari. And what I am doing? I am holding your lotus feet. By holding your lotus feet, I am in your shelter. And you please keep me in your shelter. Chai Vega Dami, Chai Dosha Shodhi. Dosha means faults. And Vega means the urge. What are these? Six arja atyahar prayasascha prajalpo niyamagraha janasangamscha lolyamcha. These six are called as arj, which was explained by Sri Rupa Goswami in Upadeshamrita. And then this veg is Vacho Vegam, Manasa Krodha Vegam, Jivha Vegam, Udara Mupastha Vegam. These six Vegas, these are called as the six Arja, which is explained by Sri Rupa Goswami in the first verse of Upadeshamrita. And what is the fault? Atyahar, prayasascha, prajalpa, niyamagraha. These are the faults which we have. We have accumulated these faults in our life. We try to take things, whatever is not necessary, more than our requirement. Like this, we are very much engaged in things. And what he says? Chaya guna deho dase. And six qualities you please give me. What is the six qualities? It is said, it is said in Upadeshamrit by Sri Rupa Goswami, Utsahat Nishchayat Dhairyat. You know this? Tattat Karma Pravartanat Sangatyagat Satovrite. These are the six, what you call that, gunas, six qualities. These things I can get only by the mercy of Vaishnava. This is what here it is saying. Rupa Goswami says, why it is said, Khaita Shvita Yata Tata Namlai Deshkal Niyamnai Sarva Siddhya, it's very easy. By eating, sleeping, whatever you are doing, just chant the holy name, you will attain Krishna. But there Rupa Goswami is saying so many things. How to understand this? Only by the mercy of Guru and by the mercy of Vaishnava, all these things will follow automatically. No need to do anything. There is nothing to struggle. It's very easy. So he says, Chai satsang deha hai amare bosechi sangir ase. I am sitting here with the desire of association with you. Bosechi sangir ase. And what you do? Deha hai amare. You please give me chai satsang. What is this? Dadati pratigrihnati guhyam akhyati prichyati. Bhungte bhojete chaiva. Shadvidam priti lakshanam. Shadvidam sangha lakshanam. The six things you please give me. First four verses of Upadeshamrit is explained in this two lines by Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur. He says, by following the footsteps of Vaishnava, by taking shelter of the Vaishnavas, we can get all these things done. No need to control our mind. And we can't control also. It's very difficult to control mind. In fact, it is impossible. How to control mind then? It is said, if you want to control your mind, surrender to Vaishnava. Lord says, Asanshayam Mahabahu. It's not so easy, but you can do two things, Abhyas and Vairagya. By performing proper practice and by performing proper vairagya, you can do this. What is the abhyas and what is the practice? The practice is to follow the instructions of the Vaishnavas. Is to follow the teachings of the Vaishnavas. And what is vairagya? To develop a kind of devotional mood, to develop love for Krishna, to develop love for Gurudev, to develop love for Vaishnava. Guru, Vaishnava, Bhagavan, all three, to develop love for them is vairagya. Why we have to do this? Ekaki amar nahi paye bal. Because this urge is so strong. Because I am all alone. That is the reason I am unable to fight with them. I am unable to conquer them. Vacho Vegam is not easy to conquer. A person who is having the habit to speak a lot, blah, 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 he can't remain silent. If there is no one, then he will speak in the air. I saw many people like that. There is no one to listen what you are speaking, but he keeps on speaking. There are such people. And anger, not so easy. All these urge, six urge, to control them is very, very difficult.
And when these urges are dominating the person, then the person is gone. So ekaki amar, why you are ekaki? You have many people around you. Why you feel yourself alone? But in the area where I really need someone, I am all alone. In that area, no one can go. No one can enter into that particular area where I really need help. Externally, there are many people around me. So he says, ekaki amar. I am all alone. Nahi pai bal. I am unable to control these six faults. They are giving so much of trouble to me. I am unable to develop the six qualities within me. Utsahat, nischayat, dhairyat. I become impatient. I become so restless. I lose my enthusiasm. And I don't like to perform the activities which are favorable for the pleasure of Krishna, for the pleasure of Guru Vaishnavas. Not possible. I am all alone. So, nahi paye bal. There is no strength. What to do? And no strength for what? Harinam Sankirtane, to chant the holy name. So who will help us in that particular area? The Vaishnavas will help us. Vaishnav and Gurudev are more subtle. So they can enter into those areas where no one can enter. Even though if we don't tell Gurudev, if we don't tell Vaishnavas, but still they understand the heart. And they know what to do, what is good for us, what is beneficial for us. Why? Because they are the one who has entrance in that area. The worldly people, they can't go there. But they can come everywhere. That is the reason it is said, the devotees are Suhrid Sarvadehinam. For all the jivas, not only for human beings, they can enter, they can understand the heart of the person who is in the form of an animal also. And they can extend their mercy upon them also. Vaishnavas are like that. Harinam Sankirtan, if I have to chant the holy name, when I feel all alone, then how can I do that? Raghunath Das Goswami, to understand, he was staying all alone. Externally, but he was alone. Every day he used to remember 1000 Vaishnavas and pay pranams to him. Means he is all the time with 1000 people. Unless you remember someone's name or something, how you can pay pranams? Raghunath Das Goswami used to pay pranams to 1000 devotees every day without fail and make dandavat pranams on their name. One Kartik, I thought I should also do something like this. In Govardhan, I was in Govardhan. So I thought I will do something like this. I said, I don't know anyhow 1000 names. So at least 32 names we can do. Starting from Krishna-2 Chaturmukh till Gurudev, I counted the names. They are like 32, 33 names are there. Remembering them, started doing dandavats. After third day, I said, it's too much for me. It's not possible to stand up and remember Krishna and do dandavat. Again Brahma, do dandavat. Again Narada, do dandavat. Not possible. Only Raghunath Das Goswami can do like that. Why he was doing? Because he sees them right in front of him. Even though you are very tired, if you see Gurudev, immediately you will make dandavats to him. We can't say, oh, it's okay, Guruji is here, tomorrow I'll do it. We'll say like that. Immediately we'll do. Because by remembering their names, he used to feel their presence near him. So he was never alone. That is the reason in the life of Raghunath Das Goswami and all other acharyas, you can see all these things were not there. But these are the things which are troubling us in our life. So that is the reason how we can overcome them. We can easily overcome them only by the mercy of Vaishnava. If a Vaishnava is truly merciful on us, what we will get? We will get the desire to chant Harinam sincerely. I heard from some Vaishnav, because I could not read that article, it is in Bengali language. I heard from some Vaishnav who is the grand disciple of Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj, that Srila Keshav Goswami Maharaj wrote an article saying that what my Gurudev wants to give us, we could not get it. Something like that, he has written an article in which it says that Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada used to say all the time, my message was not properly conveyed. What I want to say, what I want to give, no one could take it. Then his disciples used to feel bad. This incident I did not read anywhere. I heard only from his disciples. How much authentic it is, I don't know, but I liked it, so I remember it. Then Srila Keshav Goswami Maharaj told, he was talking to Prabhupada, and he said, we all the disciples try to collect each and every word coming from your lotus lips, and then we somehow try to make them together only for your pleasure, and we are publishing so many books, doing this and made marts, this, that, so many things. You are still saying that your message was not properly going. I could not understand this. Prabhupada never said anything. After the disappearance of Srila Prabhupada, 30 years later, I heard that Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj late wrote an article saying that the real message of my Gurudev was never taken by anyone. Accepting this. Why? They mean to say, when the mercy of Guru comes, what is coming, main thing which is coming, the idea, the main thing which is coming is inspiration to chant the holy name is coming. When the Vaishnavas are merciful, if they give their mercy on us, as a result of their mercy, what is coming? Harinam Sankirtane. We'll be able to chant Harinam. Sut Dara or Lakshmi Papi ke bhi hai. Even a sinful person also have wife, money, and then children. Sut means children, Dara means wife, Lakshmi means money. Even a sinful person, a criminal person also have wife, son, and all those things. But Sant Samagam Harikatha Tulasi Durlab Doi, one of the greatest poets of India, who wrote Ramcharitmanas, Goswami Tulsidas. He mentioned this. Sant Samagam Harikatha Tulasi Durlab Doi. It's very difficult to find a devotee. It's not easy. You will find Karmi, you will find Jnani, you will find Yogi, you will find many other people in this world. But a person who is living only for the pleasure of Sri Nandanandan Sri Krishna, a person who is living his life, everything is for the pleasure of Krishna, you will very hardly find such personalities. You will very difficult to find a devotee like that. Of course, now these days a new thing came. First of all, to find a devotee is very difficult. Not easy to get a devotee. And again, now people, they don't want to associate Kanishta, they don't want to associate Madhyam, they only want to associate Uttam. This is everywhere going on now. We should associate with only with Uttam Mahabhagavat. It doesn't mean that when we come in contact with Kanishta or Madhyam, just neglect them. Because even to find a Kanishta Vaishnava is also not easy. Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, someone made a comment on him, which I heard from his disciples, saying that Srila Puri Goswami Maharaj, he is always involved in deity worship. So he is like Kanishta Bhakta, because it is written that Kanishtas, they are more into worshipping the deities. So this news came to Srila Puri Goswami Maharaj, and Srila Maharaj, he said that I lived in the mutt more than 70 years, and even today I am thinking I am not even Vaishnav. But thanks to the devotee who said I am at least Kanishta. At least I am Kanishta. Vaishnava is saying means maybe possible. I can't even identify myself as Kanishta. Because they know Shastras. They know it's not easy to be a person who can be fully surrendered to Krishna. Of course he is Uttama Bhagavat, but he wants to teach us a lesson by saying that don't underestimate any Vaishnav. Vaishnav in itself is a very big thing. You can find Karmi, Jnani, Yogi, this, that, many other things. But devotee, no, not so easy. If you see, Durlabham Manusham Janmam Dehinam Kshanabhanguram Tatrapi Durlabham Manya Vaikuntha Priyadarshanam. It is said, Vaikuntha Priyadarshanam, the one who is dear to Krishna, Tatrapi Durlabham Manya, it is not so easy. First of all, to get this human form of life is very difficult. And much more difficult than to get this human form of life is to have the darshan, the glimpse of the devotees. There it is not mentioned. Vaikuntha Uttama Priyadarshanam or Madhyam Priyadarshanam or Kanishta Priyadarshanam. Vaikuntha Priyadarshanam means the one who is dear to the Lord, who is dear to Krishna. Everyone is dear to Krishna. Whoever fully surrenders to Him, whoever has nothing other than Krishna, one whose life is Krishna. In that there are different levels in Uttam, Madhyam, Kanishta and Shanta, Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya, Madhur, all these discriminations come later. But the basic thing is mentioned like that. So it is said, Sut Dara Lakshmi Papi Kevi Hai Sant Samagam. So to get such a devotee is not so easy. And after that, after getting, coming in contact with a devotee also, Harikatha is much more rare. If we don't have the desire to hear to Harikatha, then devotee, why he will give? Because he understands the importance, he understands the value of Harikatha. If we don't want, then they will not give. They will only give this to those people, those who have interest, those who wants to take it. Those who don't want, it's not for them. We don't want, so we are here in this world. If Lord wants, He could have forced us for not coming here and made her stay in His abode. But He did not do that. Why? Because the love can't be forced. It should come naturally. Devotion can't be forced. Relation can't be forced. It should be spontaneous, natural. So when we don't have, when we don't feel the natural urge of Harikatha, even after in the association of devotees also, we will not get anything. Lord Krishna and Arjuna were friends for 125 years. But he spoke to him, Bhagavad Gita, in the end of their pastimes. Almost it was the conclusion of their pastimes. That time, he spoke. Lord was in this planet for almost 125 years and he fought 127 battles. Very interesting. And but he gave the message, even though they were staying together, but he gave this message in the middle of the battlefield. Why? Because Arjun surrendered to him, saying that I am your disciple, I surrender to you. Please give me proper guidance. Please tell me what should I do. Then the message was conveyed. Like that only devotees, they don't force Harikatha. They will tell us, come. But if you come, then only you will be given. If you don't come, by force they will catch you and they won't pour on your ears. So it is said, Harikatha is not so easy to get. So if a devotee is truly merciful on us, what he gives Krishna Katha. If he gives Krishna Katha, then our desire to chant the holy name will arise in our heart. By associating with devotees, if we are not inspired to chant, means there is some fault in our association. We are not properly associating. We should change our mood and we should learn to associate with the devotees properly. Vaishnava Sangete Mon Anandit Anukshan. When Vaishnavas are meeting, so much of a bliss is coming. It's not that he came, Baba. We have to tolerate him. What to do? So there, you know, excitement is there. Why? Because soul feels blissful inside. That I am getting, I am very hungry, I am very thirsty. Who will quench my thirst? If a person who is thirsty, he needs water to drink. If a person who is hungry, he needs food to eat. Then only his pain is like relieved. Like the urge, soul also wants food. And the food of the soul is only Harinam. Is only the Krishna Katha. Where we can get? We can get from devotees. That is the reason it is said, Vaishnava Sangete Mon, mind, in the association, in the company of Vaishnavas, Anandita Anukshan, each and every moment is feeling blissful. Why? Sada Hai Krishna Parasang. All the time, the only topic discussed is Krishna Katha. For some time discussing Krishna Katha, after that, okay, how are you? How is your wife and children? Okay. Nothing like that. Only thing they have, the discussion, is only Krishna Katha. So when there is Krishna Katha coming from the lotus lips of Vaishnavas, what is happening? Potency is coming. That Katha is becoming more and more potent. If you see Bhagavan Kapil, he says to Mother Devhuti, Satam Prasangan Mamavirya Samvido. You go and associate with my devotees and discuss. What? Mamavirya Samvido. My glories, those who are very potent. Why it is potent? Because it is coming from the lips of Vaishnavas. It is coming from the lips of devotees. So that is the reason it is said, Ekaki Amar Nahi Paye Bol Harinam Sankirtane. I am alone if your mercy is not there. I am hearing Harikatha or I am reading books by myself. I am doing some sadhana somehow. But if I am doing all this without your mercy, then it's not going to help me. I am alone now. So that is the reason there is no strength to perform Harinam. Few days we will chant, after that we give up. That inspiration will go away. If you see in Srimad Bhagavatam also, it is said, Avaishnava Mukhodgirnat, if even Srimad Bhagavat Katha, Bhagavatamritam, if it is coming from the lips of Avaishnavas, then what is said? Shravanam naiva kartavyam You should not listen to it. Why? Because it works like sarpochishta yathapaya. It works like the milk touched by the mouth, lips of a serpent, which is very dangerous. Which means they want to tell when Harikatha is coming from the lips of pure devotees, then only it is potent. If it is not coming from the lips of pure devotees, then it is not potent. Who is pure devotee? The one who is living only for the pleasure of Krishna. No, no. Where we will find such people? Again it is said, the one who is trying to follow the path led by the pure devotees. They are also, we can follow them. They are following pure devotees. They are following the teachings of pure devotees. They are trying, they are practicing the teachings of pure devotees. And they are trying to implement the teachings of pure devotees in their life. And then they are singing glories of the Lord. Even that is considered very pure. Like that. Then that potency is coming, that energy is coming. If not, not possible. Tumi kripa kari shraddha bindu diya deha Krishna naam dhane. Now what he is saying, tumi kripa kari. You please be kind to me. And shraddha bindu diya. Even I don't want complete shraddha. Why? I am not qualified for that. Only one drop of faith, shraddha bindu. Bindu means one drop of faith you just give me, that is sufficient for me. Shraddha, if here is asking shraddha, drop of shraddha, not complete shraddha. And then sadhu sangha, then bhajan kriya, then anarthani vritti, then ruchi, nishtha, asakti, bhav, prem. He is asking for a drop of shraddha. Shraddha is also not so easy. So that is the reason it is said, tumi kripa kari. By whose mercy we can get Shraddha? By the mercy of Vaishnavas. Directly a person who has fallen from the marginal potency of the Lord, all of a sudden Shraddha is awakened. How it is possible? Is it possible? Person fallen from the marginal potency of the Lord, being envious of the Lord, wants to enjoy this world, and he has fallen here. Now immediately he developed Shraddha. To develop Shraddha, we need the mercy of Vaishnavas. So that is the reason before Shraddha also we need to do Sadhu Sangha. By the mercy of Sadhu, by the mercy of Vaishnavas, we will develop Shraddha. After Shraddha, we surrender to Sri Guru. So it's very important. Shraddha Shabde Shudrida Nishche. Firm determination, Shraddha means. What is that? Only for the pleasure of Krishna, if I am doing something, everything, that is the only thing. Nothing else is needed. Everything is accomplished only by serving Krishna. To understand this is Shraddha. Shraddha is bhakti actually, devotion. So anyhow, what he says, Deha Krishna Naam Dhane. Dhan means wealth, treasure. What is the treasure? Krishna Naam. Deha means please give. By giving a drop of faith, you please give me the treasure of the name of Krishna. Then what happens? We understand the value of the holy name. What we have got. Who can give us? Vaishnava can give us. If not, not possible. Why? Further he says, Krishna se tomar, Krishna dite par. Krishna se tomar, Krishna is yours. Krishna belongs to you. It doesn't belong to anyone. Krishna dite par, and you are capable of giving Krishna. Tomar shakati ache. What is he saying? You are having that power to give Krishna.
No one else can give. If you see Mahabharata, after the battle is over, Krishna and all together with Pandavas, Kunti, they all went to see Pitama Bhishma in the battlefield. When Yudhishthira became the king, and then they all went to see him in the battlefield. Now, Pitama Bhishma, he is blessing everyone. But when Arjun came to him, he is asking him. He did pranams to Arjun and he says, please give this Krishna to me. He is saying this to Arjun, that I want him, you give him to me, you can give me. So like this, why? Because devotee, they always keep Lord in his heart. Vaishnava, Govinda kahena mama Vaishnava paran. Vaishnava is my life. Tomar hriday sada Govinda vishram. Whose heart Govinda is taking rest? In the heart of pure devotees. Srila Bharti Maharaj, he always makes some humor with this and says, why Lord is resting in the heart of devotee? Maharaj says, because he doesn't have any demand. If he is resting there, he is not disturbed. If he has to rest somewhere, Karmi, Jnani, Yogi, all these people, they will say, Dhanam Dehi, give money, give this, give that. But devotee, they don't demand anything from the Lord. So Lord, he can peacefully take rest in the heart of his devotees. Maharaj says like that. So somehow, and what Lord is saying, that Vaishnava is my life. When someone becomes the life of the Lord, when that person fully surrenders to Krishna, when that person knows nothing other than Krishna. In Bhagavad Gita, Lord says, my devotee, he knows nothing other than me, so I also know nothing other than him. Because he says, also he says, ye yathamam prapadyante tanstate bhajamyaham. If you make Krishna your life, Krishna makes you his life. That is the word he has given. So devotees, Vaishnavas, their life is Krishna. For them, nothing else is there. So that is the reason Krishna is bound to them. Anupragyami aham nityam yashvatantra ivadvijo. Lord says to Durvasa, even though I may look independent, but still I am fully dependent. I follow my devotees. Why? Because of their devotion, they have attracted me. They attracted me because of their devotion. When the devotion becomes more and more and more condensed, and then when the devotion becomes loving devotion, what happens? One very special quality devotee gets, Sri Krishna Akarshani Chesa, the ability to attract Krishna. The ability to attract Krishna, Lord is attracted. Now, till now, Lord is attracting everyone. Krishna is attracting everyone. Everyone gets attracted because of Krishna. And now here, devotee is attracting Krishna. That ability a devotee gets in Prema Bhakti. That is the speciality of Prema Bhakti. Devotee attracts him like this. And Lord could not remain after that. That is the speciality. You can see it happened quite a number of times in the case of our previous acharyas also. Sanatan Goswami attracted Madan Mohan. Madan Mohan came and he stayed there only. Madan Mohan came to Sanatan Goswami and Sanatan Goswami gave up everything, renounced everything, but now the deities are there. Madan Mohan is there, he has to cook something. He is begging flour from some Vrajavasis and making some laddus, throwing in the fire.
There is no microwave oven or something like that. So he has to put fire and throw everything in the fire and not waiting. Busy with his chanting, busy with his other seva. After some time when he comes out in external conscious, then he sees the fire is finished, somewhere it's burned too much and somewhere it's not even a little it is cooked. He somehow cleans it and then put them in one leaf and keep near Madan Mohan and asks him to eat. Eat. We all know this. And what Madan Mohan says after eating, he says, at least if you can provide little salt, I can manage somehow. Which means how difficult it is to eat. So he is asking, please arrange for some little salt. He says, not possible. If today you are asking salt, tomorrow you will ask ghee. Some other day you will ask vegetable. Later you will say, cook something. If you want, you stay here. I can't provide anything to you. This is what Sanatana Goswami says to Madan Mohan. But deep in the heart, he is feeling pain. When I was the Prime Minister, Lord never gave any instructions to me. He never asked me anything. Today I am in a condition I can't even provide little salt for him. How painful it is. And he was feeling very sad in his heart. Very harshly he said this to Madan Mohan, that it's not possible for me. Manage yourself. Madan Mohan managed everything by himself, but he did not leave Sanatana Goswami. He remained with him all the time. Why? Because he is bound to him. He can't leave him. What is making him bound to him? The only loving devotional service he has for Krishna. Raghunandan Thakur, son of Mukunda, small boy. Mukunda, he was a doctor. So he went out for some work. That time Mukunda, he says to Raghunandan, that my dear son, you should make offering to the Lord. He said, okay, I'll do it. And he asked how to do, he don't know, small boy. He says, take the plate, keep near the altar and tell him to eat, he will eat. The way we tell to new pujaris, he also said the same way. But Raghunandan took it very deep in his heart. He went inside the altar, kept near the Lord and he says, eat. Now he is not eating. Gopina khau boli kandite kandite, started crying. He is not eating, so he is crying. What to do now? Lord has to appear there and eat everything. We know this. Why? He is bound to that love of devotee. How much devotion he is having that he could not stay there anymore. And he has to appear and eat everything. And the plate is completely empty. When he came back to his mother, she saw, where is the prasad? For us, offering counts along, including other people we have. Generally, when we cook, the plate, we know because it will come as it is outside. So now, when his mother, she saw the plate, there is nothing inside. She was thinking that what is happening? So she thought maybe he has eaten because he is scared his father will beat him or something. Then his father came and asked, where is the plate? Any prasadam is left? He said, no, he has eaten everything. Next time Mukund wants to take a test of Raghunandan. So he says, today you offer bhog. And then he went out again, he came back and hiding inside and watching what's happening. His mother, she made nice coconut laddu. big laddu. So one laddu she brought in one plate and said, Raghunandan, offer it to Lord. You offer this to Gopinath. Raghunandan thought, one laddu, why to take plate and all? He just took the laddu inside. He left the plate and then he gave it to Gopinath and he says, eat. Now Gopinath, he knows that his father is standing outside, so he is not eating. Again the child started crying. That day you have eaten, today if you don't eat, my father will be angry, thinking that maybe I did not offer properly. You are planning to make me like beaten from my father. And then he is crying, small child. Gopinath, he could not remain. He took it and he has eaten half. Immediately Mukund, he jumped into the room. That half eaten laddu remained in the hand of Gopinath. Mukund, like literally crying, and accepted Raghunandan as his guru in one form. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asks him, he says, no, he is my guru. Bound by the loving devotion of the devotee, Lord immediately reciprocates. And that devotee, if he wants, he can give Krishna to anyone. Krishna has many cousins. He has one cousin. His name is Stok Krishna. Stok is one name of his, one of his cousins. It's not there in Bhagavatam, some other place it is there. He wanted to give something to Krishna on his birthday, on Janmashtami. He was thinking what to do, and he found one person, very dirty, unclean. It's like you can see that this person is like frustrated in life. He brought him and he told Krishna that you have to take him. And he accepted him. He accepted. Narad Goswami came to the Lord and he said, I initiated one person today. Very good. But he chants Mara. Not Ram. He chants Mara. We have to accept him. Lord accepted him. He became Valmiki. If a devotee wants to give Krishna to anyone, Lord has to go. That's it. Why? Because Lord is bound to his devotion. He can't say, no, I can't go here. There is no such excuse. He has to go. That's all. That is why it is said, Krishna se tumar, Krishna is yours. You have full right on him. Because you have given full right on yours to Krishna. So he also gave his full right to you. When you say, Maravi Rakhavi Jo Ichha Tohara. Heard this? Nitya Das Prati Tu Adhikar. Yes, you have full right on your eternal servant, Nitya Dasa Priti Tuva Adhikar. You have full right on this eternal servant of yours. So, Maravi Rakhavi, Jo Ichha Tohar, if you want me to protect me, then do it. And if you want to finish me, do it, I have no problem. I am your eternal servant. When a person says like this and surrenders to Krishna, what Lord will do after that? Lord can't remain. After that, he can't remain. He has to give himself completely to that devotee. That is the reason it is said, Krishna se tomar. Krishna is yours, only yours. Krishna belongs to his devotees. He doesn't belong to anyone. He doesn't belong to Duryodhan. That is the reason Duryodhan was offering so many things to him. He was not ready to accept anything. In the golden plate, very nicely arranged, many dishes, many things. And what Lord says, not possible, my dear. because we don't have love with each other. You don't love me, that is confirmed. If you love me, you would have accepted my proposal. But you are not ready to do that. Why? Because you don't love me, you love your ego. And second thing, I am neither hungry. I am not hungry. Yes, of course, Lord is never hungry. That is there. If I am hungry, I would have eaten. But he is rushing to the house of Vidur where he doesn't have anything. Vidur went outside to beg. He begs and then he eats, he survives. He and his wife survives with the food they get by begging. He never took salary from Dhritarashtra. That is the reason when they had this battle in Kurukshetra, he did not go there. But all others have to go because they are paid. Everyone is paid there. Anyhow, that is different subject. Krishna went to the house of Vidur and there he is eating the peel of banana. Is he that hungry? And very happily eating it. Why? Bound by the love of the wife of Vidur. He is bound by her love and that is making him eat the peel of banana and not cooked peel, raw. And that too banana, she is throwing banana and she is lost and feeding him the peel and he is eating the peel. A person, if someone really is crazy for us and someone wants to die for us, but when they see you and they becomes like crazy and then they bring some peel and then try to feed, you will slap one and you will say, calm down. But he is not saying anything. Bound by the love of the wife of Vidur, he is eating the peel. That is Krishna. And that is the devotee. Such devotee can give Krishna to anyone. And Krishna can't say, I don't want to go there. He has to go. And Lord also very happily goes. The reason is he knows by going there, by following his devotee, his supremacy is never damaged. He remains the Supreme Lord only. Why? Because devotees are of that mood. They want to serve him. They don't want to dominate him. And no one can dominate Krishna. They love him. Sudama, he kept right here. Where he will carry, there is no handbag. He kept here and walking like this. And when he went inside the palace of Dwarikadish, he was so hesitating, so he just kept it secretly. And then if he keeps somewhere else, Krishna will snatch it. He tried to keep somewhere hiding like this and then he is sitting. From there also Krishna took, snatch it and he has eaten. Is he that hungry? Bound by the love of the wife of Sudama, he has eaten it. Bound by the love of mother of Madhumangal and Madhumangal, he has to drink that very sour buttermilk. Because all these mothers, all the mothers of Sakhas, they are making different delicious food items. Because they go for picnic and they share from each other's things. So Yashoda, she knows that many other boys are going, she also cooks so much. And other, they all cook so much and they all bring. But Madhumangal is very poor. He don't have anything much. And his mother, she also had the desire that if Krishna, I could offer him something. But there is nothing to make. And Madhumangal also, he also has the desire, I want to offer something for him. But I have nothing to eat. And this sour buttermilk is there. If he drinks it, his taste will be spoiled. And Madhumangal is secretly hiding and drinking.